called Build It, a toolkit for nurturing intergenerational spiritual community, and it's the fruit of about 5 years of work and maybe 15 or 20 people working on it on a youth ministries committee, because the members of this committee were people who had a deep concern about a sense of separation among teens and young adults from their meetings, and meetings having a sense of separation from the teens and young adults in their meetings, or who originally came from their meetings and left and lost touch. So the youth ministries committee visited meetings and met with each other and learned about what this concern looked like in different meetings, and also what meetings were doing to address the concern, and gathered good practices and best practices from 15 different yearly meetings and lots of monthly meetings about what meetings did to help nurture a sense of community among and including people aged 14 to 35, with people in that age group and also with people outside of that age group. So that's what this is. In technical terms, it's 6 narrative chapters and 38 activities. It's 84 pages. The ones of you who like numbers are all lighting up now. And I guess we have to pass it around again. So it's okay if I take it. That's a lot. So, and you're welcome to pass. You don't have to take any. I don't hate them. I want them. So the book has 38 activities, including activities for deepening, including activities that we just played. The 2 activities we played are exactly in the book. And the activities we're going to play were in the book as well. The activities are designed to help people build connections. I should put the advertisement gesture down. To help people build connections, not just to say, oh, you're older, I'm younger, I'm older, you're younger, we should get to know each other, but among people as individual people to get to know each other, because that's what community is individual people getting to know each other and getting to work together and learning each other so that they can identify each other's gifts. Did you want to say, Emily has worked on this book also, do you want to say anything else about the book? You can pass.
No, it's fine. A lot of the youth ministries committee was made up of people of all ages, so it wasn't it was a combined effort, and we were just kind of like doing it together. We were learning as we went, and brought the experiences we had with bad and good meetings. So this really came out of the hope that we could make change in meetings and really work together to build relationships across all of the age and race and class and all the other isms that kind of separate us from one another. So this is just some ideas that we came up with, and we hope that, you know, everyone brings whatever games and activities and experiences they have to their own meeting. So this is just a starting place.
So that's in general what this game is and where the games we're playing came from. And if it's something that you want to take to your meeting for any of the committees for ministry or for yourself to just initiate doing things or find someone else in your meeting to help you or to do it because you're not going to do public speaking. You know, the idea is that this has a lot of useful, thank you very much, resources. A lot of useful resources that can be used in different ways, whether you want to plan a service day or just play a game together at a monthly potluck or have a resource for some activities at a retreat. It has queries, it has short lists of further reading books and pamphlets and websites on a variety of different topics. So it really is a toolkit in the sense of you can pick up what's useful from it, and it has a lot of useful things, but you don't sit down and do everything in chapter 1 and check it off the list. It's not that kind of thing. Oh, you can read it cover to cover, it doesn't take long, and it is interesting and well written. So. Okay, shall we move on to the next game? That was enough, you've almost finished your chapter. Alright. Oh, and it also has a skit. Did I say that?
No.
It didn't. No, I didn't. Okay. It has a skit, it has Quaker Frequently Asked Questions, the 12 How-To's, and it has this skit, A History of Quakerism in 10 Easy Points. And it goes through Quakers from the beginning with George Fox and Margaret Bell in England coming to America, and then all the splits and schisms. It was written by a young adult friend, Maya Wright. I did a presentation earlier this week, and her mom was in a group of 6 people. That's my daughter. And I said, wow, that was great. And my personal favorite line from that skit is, thou art a Methodist. and it's funny.